Hi, my name's Dan and I'm part of So We Stand, which is a network of people and communities taking action for environmental justice. I wish I could be with you today, but I'm sure Becky and Irie will be mobilising the masses. My part of the workshop will be talking about the role of direct action in fighting for environmental justice. When we talk about environmental justice, we're talking about the unequal burden of environmental and social problems on specific communities which weren't usually perpetrated by them. For example, what we can see is the impacts of climate change in the global south is communities in Africa and Asia who are facing the frontline impacts of climate change, such as drought and famine and rising sea levels, they're not the ones usually who created the problem. It's the people in the West, in the banks, in the corporations and in the carbon-heavy industries who've created the problem. So therefore, we see that environmental issues are an injustice because it's an issue of civil rights and inequality. And so what I've had a bit of experience in is the role of direct action in creating social and environmental positive change. Direct action throughout history has had a rich tradition of resistance and success in tackling the problems of our time. Without direct action, the world would be a very different place. 100 years ago, you look at the role that the suffragettes in the UK played in fighting for the right for women to vote. 50 years ago in America, in the civil rights movement, direct action was employed to fight for racial equality. And all over the world, people are taking action into their own hands to fight for environmental and social responsibility and social justice. The reason why people take direct action is for many reasons, because it works, as we've seen throughout history. It's because people lose faith and become frustrated with the powers that be who say one thing and do the other. You know, we hear from the United Nations that they're going to take action against the Israeli state for the occupation in Palestine, but are not taking the necessary action. We see the governments across the world saying they're taking action on climate change, but we're seeing emissions continuing to rise rather than fall. So that's why people and communities get frustrated with the powers that be, realise there's inherent problems there, and take action into their own hand. And it's about responsibility. When you see a problem, it's about relying on your community and having faith in your ability to take action. And there's all kinds of direct action methods that can be used as well, from direct interventions, such as blockading airports to stop the pollution, to blockading roads being built to stop further pollution on the local communities, to blockading arms manufacturers who fund the Israeli state. Direct action has been used for a whole number of campaigns in the UK recently. But it's not just direct interventions as well, it's generating awareness on an issue. So it could be targeting politicians and supergluing yourself to them, or covering them in green custard as a kind of peaceful joke to heighten bollocks. Oh shit, will we have to start again?
No, we're all right, we can cut it.
Okay. or publicity stunts, clambering on top of buildings, playing jokes and pranks on politicians who are part of the problem to highlight the issue and raise awareness. And lastly, direct action is being employed to support the struggle in ending the occupation and to support the Palestinian people for the fight for social and environmental justice. You know, in the UK, we're in the belly of the beast in the sense that we've got Eden Springs, the company which is exploiting water resources in Palestine, on our doorstep, where there's actions all the time to tackle Eden Springs crimes in Palestine. There's actions against the Jewish National Fund, for example, who steal trees from Palestine and plant them in the Israeli settlements. So what we're seeing is the connections between social and environmental problems. And if we are to ever hope to tackle the occupation in Palestine, we've got to tackle it from all fronts, from social and environmental fronts. And I hope you have a really, really good workshop. I wish I could be there, but I can't fly because I choose to tackle the aviation industry, so it would take me too long to get to Palestine and back. But I hope to see you soon and wish you all the best in the struggle against the occupation. And we in the West will do, we in the UK will do everything that we can. Thanks.